Okay, you have understand for now for the preparation of the full text invoice and the summary text invoice, and in case it has changing of the number of the number of the VAT when it has the sum of the transaction activity change that make the value of the output read by the seller charging is increased or decreased, they can issue the debit note for credit or the credit note. Okay. However, as I already explained to you that it's just another type of the tax invoice that can be used as the evidence for claiming of the input tax, okay, or the claiming of the VAT, that is the government receive, okay. So we will continue on that. The receipt that is can be used as a tax invoice is this the receipt that issued by the custom department and revenue department. When the person import the product from abroad or from the foreign country, they have to make the custom clearance. They have to declare the value of the product or that they import from the harmony. We call the harmonized system in the custom department. This will be the base for the calculation of the value of the product to figure out the number of the VAT. By the way, when they import the product, the tax base will be the value of the CAF price, and but in case of the exporting will be the FOB price that will apply for the case of the tax base verification number, the number. So that case, okay, the receipt that issued by the custom department will be used as the evidence for the claiming of the input tax by the taxpayer by the VAT registrant. And another one is excise department, because some of the product is liable to the excise tax too. So the receipt that issued by the excise department for the collection of the VAT is also be the used as the evidence for claiming of the VAT by the VAT registrant too. For another one, for the receipt by the revenue department is the receipt for the submission of the VAT based on the value of the receipt that they have the international transaction. Okay, for example, for the service that perform in foreign country and the VAT registrant in Thailand use that service in Thai, they when they make the payment of the service fee to the foreign operator, they have to submit the number of the VAT using the form we call PP36, and when they submit the tax for the VAT under the form PP36, the revenue department will issue the receipt. This receipt can be used as the tax invoice for the claiming of the input tax. Okay, that's the other type of the tax invoice that I will not cover in this class, because it's not effect to the preparation or the compliance for the administration by the taxpayer. Okay, the next one is for the case of the tax invoice is lost. As I already told you that we can bring the use the duplicating of the tax invoice as evidence for claiming of the input tax. Okay, duplicate tax invoice is can be prepared if it has the request from the purchaser of the goods or the recipient of the service, which the tax invoice is lost or damaged. Okay, they are possible to ask for the VAT registrant, who is the seller, to copy by making the photocopy from the copy of the tax invoice that the seller keep it for the preparation of the output tax report, and the seller has the authorized and to prove that exists. Make the photocopy from the original one is the real transaction that they have been collect for the output VAT. Okay, so this one they are required, the seller required for making the photocopy and issue for the duplicate tax invoice, giving to the customer, giving to the buyer, who is the tax invoice for claiming of the input tax. Okay, the duplicate tax invoice must show the serial number of the duplicate tax invoice, date of issuance, summary explanation for the cause, for the reason that why we have to by the VAT registrant must issue the duplicate tax invoice and the signature for the person who are signing to issue the tax invoice as an authorization signature. These are the requirements for making the duplicate tax invoice. Another one, sometimes in business case, the tax invoice is prepared together with another commercial document, okay, prepared as a one set, as a set of the document. They are, for example, of the commercial documents such as delivery order, tax invoice, and receive as a one set when they prepare and giving for this and give this one to the customer and use as a supporting document for the accounting record of the taxpayer of the VAT registrant. Okay, in this case, it has the additional condition that if the tax invoice is prepared together with another commercial document for the company of the VAT registrant, and it is not the first copy of the set, okay, it shall have another word in show in the tax invoice and another document in the set. The word that they have to show is the first one, not the tax invoice. Okay, from this case you can see that the tax invoice is in the second copy, in the second page. Okay, so when it is in the second page, the preparation is will prepare as a one set. It will be the copy one. So the first page or another page, the third page, the fourth page, if it is not the tax invoice, it must show the word not tax invoice in every page. And another one, in every page, it must show the word document issue in set in every page or in the set of the document. And in every page, that is the copy of the tax invoice. Sometimes the commercial document, for example, this one is a receipt, but it's also be the copy of the tax invoice too. So it means in this page, it must have the word copy, the copy as the word in this page too, as the copy of the tax invoice. Okay. These are the requirement for the additional requirement for the preparation of the tax invoice. Okay. Seller, when they sell the product at the tax point, they have to issue the tax invoice. Okay, it says the original one and the copy one at least. The original one will be given to the customer or the buyer. The buyer will receive this original tax invoice and reveal that this tax invoice is deductible input tax or not when they're making the calculation as a one of the row of the VAT registrant when they're making the calculation of VAT liability in each month. Okay, so output tax in the position of the seller, output tax is number of the VAT that the seller collect or collectible from the buyer at the tax point. Calculate from the tax base, which is the goods or the service value according to the tax base of such transaction. Okay, multiply with the tax rate, 7% apply for the case of the consumption is in Thai, 0% is applied for the case of the consumption in abroad or some consumption is in Thai but in the special case such as for selling to the embassy. Okay, input tax is this amount of the VAT that the VAT registrant who is the buyer in the position of the buyer has been collect or collectible by the seller. This one is the input tax that they have pay to the revenue department via the seller, and they receive the tax invoice as an evidence for claiming. This one, although they have the tax invoice, but it has a lot of condition for proving that it is input tax that is deductible or not. So this one we will learn again. We will learn in the subsequent one in the following slide for the condition of deductible input tax. Okay, deductible input tax is number of the VAT or number of VAT that the buyer pay to the seller. Okay, and would like to claim it in the VAT calculation. So the number that is deductible is all thing that is not called as non-deductible input tax. Okay. For the investigation tip between the seller and buyer for the input tax on such tax invoice. Okay. Example that it has the person who sell the product and ABC is a buyer. ABC receive the tax invoice from a beta company who is the seller and would like to claim for input tax. Okay. When they claim for input tax, for example, this case for claiming of the input tax 30,000 baht, it can be cross-checked because beta company will report the sale amount and report the output tax. Beta company will report under the system that they have collect the output VAT from the buyer by using the tax invoice in the name of customer ABC. If the ABC who is the buyer, when they claim, revenue department will cross check to the output VAT report of the seller. If the output VAT report of the seller show the number of the VAT with the same amount and the same name of the purchaser, this one will be valid for the claiming of the input tax by one VAT registrant, by a VAT registrant. Okay, and this one will show it in the VAT return as because they have to report. Okay, so non-deductible input tax is the number of the tax that is cannot claim. Is this not allowed to claim? What are they? The first one, the tax invoice is missing. It does not have the document, or the document it may be damaged or lost. How to solve this problem? They can be asking the seller to issue the duplicate tax invoice for using, okay, this one in the preparation of input tax report. The second one is a tax invoice contains the element which is not incorrect or insufficient in substance. So they have the tax invoice for proving of the number of the input tax that they pay. However, the input the tax invoice does not contain the required element for using, such as does not have the value added tax show separately, or it may have some of such as, for example, tax identification of the purchaser does not present in the tax invoice. Tax identification of the seller does not present in the tax invoice. These are the requirement elements that should be shown in the tax invoice, and it is not shown, it is missing this tax invoice. Although they actually pay for the VAT, but this tax invoice is does not correct according to the law. So the input tax cannot claim. The number of the VAT cannot claim as an input tax. Okay. The third one, input tax is not directly connected to the business carry on. Okay. SMS look like for the corporate income tax if the expense is not related to the business of the company. It will not be treated as an expense in the calculation of the net profit. SMS of that for the calculation of the VAT. If the input if the VAT that originate from the transaction that is not related to the company business or the VAT registrant business, this input VAT cannot be claimed too. Okay, for example, that they making the business of selling of the furniture, but it has the input value from the transaction that is the expense of the brokerage fee for the trading the security in the stock market. And this one is not the business that related to the company, because it may be the brokerage fee for personnel expense of the director of the company of the Varejistan. This brokerage fee or VAT will not be deductible in the calculation of VAT calculation. Okay. Next one is input tax that is originate from the entertainment expense. Okay. Sections 82/5 for bracket number 4. This one is the input tax that I have already told you that. Just remember, is this input VAT from the entertainment expense, it cannot be deducted. So when you're making the calculation of the entertainment expense for the calculation of the net profit, shall be the number of the entertainment as cost plus with the VAT. Okay, this is the reason input tax originate from the entertainment expense, it cannot be deducted in the calculation of the VAT in each month. Input tax under the tax invoice issued by the person who are not authorized to issue the tax invoice, because they may not be VAT registered, or they may not be the person who are authorized. So if you got the tax, if the VAT registered got the tax invoice by the unauthorized person, that tax invoice will be treated as non-deductible input VAT. Okay. To solve this problem is that when you have the business deal with the other supplier, is this required for you to ask for the certificate? Because when the business operator register themselves with the revenue department to be VAT registered, they will got the certification of the VAT registration. Okay, they will got this certificate from the revenue department. You can use this certificate to validate that they are VAT registered under the registration of the revenue department or not, at least to prove for the existence of the right and authorization of them to issue the tax invoice, because we have to use that tax invoice for claiming of the input VAT with in the position of the buyer. Okay, another one for the number 6, input tax originates from the passenger car with the seat not more than 10 seats. Okay, under the law governing for the excise tariff, this one, as I already explained to you too, that just remember that when you have the expense related to the passenger car for the renting or the buying of the passenger car, the number of the VAT you have to include in the cost of the passenger car too, or the rental expense too, because number of the VAT originate from this transaction is this not allowed to be deductible in the calculation of the VAT. Okay, under the number 6 condition. Okay, number 7, input tax that in summary of the tax invoice, this one is cannot be deductible in the calculation of the VAT too. Input tax that originate and the particular item is not prepared by preprint or computerized. Okay, this is the additional condition, as I told you that if it is preprint or it is the computerized, it should be the wholly document preparation for the preprint or computerized. So supplier name, address, or tax ID which does not preprint or computerized, it's just be written as or using the stamp, this is not allowed. So when you receive this type of the document as a tax invoice, it will not be used for claiming of input VAT. Okay, next one for the word tax invoice. For the word tax invoice that is not preprint, is also not deductible as the input tax too. The next one for the input tax that originate from the construction of the building. Okay, the construction of the building and use that immovable property for selling, it will be the business that's not related to the VAT. Okay, you can see that if we back to the VAT exemption business, okay, selling of the immovable property is the SBT business, specific business tax. Renting of immovable property, even if it's not selling, selling of the immovable property is a SBT business, SBT specific business tax. You have to bring that value of the sale of the immovable property, pay the specific business tax, not pay the VAT. However, this is the renting, okay? Immovable property that is used for renting. Renting of the business, renting of immovable property is VAT exemption. VAT exemption is mean that it does not liable to collect VAT or is does not require to be VAT resistant. But when you when the company or the VAT resistant, they may construct the building and use that building, right? So the service for the construction building is VAT service, is the VAT business. So the contractor will charge VAT to the VAT resistant, who is the buyer, who is the purchaser, okay? And the purchaser recognize this as the capital expenditure. This building include VAT. If they use this for renting out, okay, because VAT is not related to the business for VAT business. So VAT that they have to be to pay for the construction of the building shall not be claimable. So it will be a part of cost of the building. Okay. This will be a part of cost of the building. But if they use the VAT resistant, construct the building and use this building for VAT business, okay, for VAT business, such as they use the office as the head office and their business is the VAT business. So number of the VAT that they use for construct, that they pay for the construction of the building, is can be claimed. However, under this condition is that if on the first day, the building that they the immovable property or the building that they construct, that they build, is used for VAT business, but it subsequently use it in non-VAT business or the VAT exemption, input VAT cannot be claimed. Input VAT cannot be used to, okay, cannot be claimed for the calculation of the VAT liability in each month. However, this is applied for 3 years after the construction complete. It means that the first day that the construction is completed, count for 3 years. During this time, okay, during this time for 3 years after the completion of the construction, they change the purpose of using of this this immovable property from VAT business to non-VAT business. Input VAT will be non-deductible input tax. So in this case, they have to making the additional submission. Okay, they have to making the additional submission to return the number of unclaimed input VAT back to the revenue department. And this one will be calculate for the surcharge 1.5% per month that will be cover it at the part of the sanction. Okay, these are the meaning of section bracket number 10 for input tax, which is originate from the construction of the immovable property and intention on the first day used for VAT, but subsequently used in non-VAT business within 3 years after the completion of the construction. Next one is the input tax that originate from the purchasing of the property using for or intend to use in the business, which is not liable to the VAT. Okay, for example, the convenience store. Okay, the convenience store. The VAT exemption is selling the agricultural product, the meat or the animal lifeless. Okay. But in that convenience store, they may sell the bread or the juice, okay, the bottle juice. The selling of the bottle of juice is this the wet business. But selling of the meat or the agricultural product is this an exemption. So they may example that they buy the refrigerator for using of showing the bottle of juice and showing the meat in the same refrigerator. The buying of the refrigerator is the refrigerator is the wet product. So buying of the refrigerator is will be half the VAT. So number of this VAT, if it's used for selling of the juice only, is this VAT for wet business. But this refrigerator used for selling of the bottle of juice and meat. Meat is non-VAT. So VAT on refrigerator for the part of meat cannot be claimed because it is a kind of non-deductible input tax. Only a part of the VAT that related to selling of the bottle of juice, that one will be claiming, able to claim for the number of the VAT on the refrigerator. This is the meaning of number 11. Okay, next one for the input tax. Okay, that appear on the tax invoice, which the tax invoice in the form does not have the word copy. This will be applied for the case of document issue instead as an additional requirement for the preparation of the tax invoice. Okay, next one for the input tax that has been amended in the particular item, which is the requirement. Okay, if it is preprint, it should be preprint. If it is computerized, it should be computerized. But if it's preprint and it has some changing, some amendment with the writing, this one will be the amendment of the requirement of particular item which are required under the law. This type of the tax invoice will be non-deductible input tax. Okay, another one that about the input tax that originate from the purchasing of the goods, receiving of the service, and is it applied to use or intend to apply to use if for both business, even for the VAT or non-VAT. Number of the VAT should be computed by average between VAT and non-VAT. Okay, this one will be the number 14. Okay, so at this point, you can see that when the tax point incur, seller will charge the VAT to the buyer and give the original tax invoice that the seller has the duty, has the responsibility to prepare, give to the buyer. Buyer will review that original tax invoice can be used for claiming of the input tax in their VAT calculation or not. And the seller shall use the copied one for the tax invoice for the preparing of the their report. Okay, so at this point, when the seller sells the product, they use the copy tax invoice for preparing of the output tax report in the position of the seller. These are required to prepare within 3 days after the tax point incurred. After that, for the preparation and the buying transaction of the purchaser, original tax invoice, they have to review that it is deductible or not. If it is non-deductible, this tax invoice will be excluded out from the report. For the amount of the input tax, which is allowed to include in the calculation of the input tax. They will use for prepare the input tax report. Okay, the report that they have to prepare according to the price of the business. This is a one set of the document or a one set of the report that they have to prepare for one registrant for one place of the business. That they are the first one input tax report, second one output tax report, and the third one for stock report. Okay, input tax report will summarize for all of deductible input tax. Output tax report will prepare by based on the total. The whole the total document of the tax invoice that they issue in the month. And in case their business is selling of the product, it will have the stock, so they have to prepare the stock report too. The report should be formatted according to the notification of the Director General. The example of the report is this shown to you in the sheet for the particular item or the format that should be shown. Okay, VAT registrant is subject to prepare the VAT report on tax month basis. This should be prepared on monthly. Okay, output tax for the month, input tax for the month, and stock movement for the month. Okay, we are preparing of the tax calculation for July. Okay, we will have to prepare this set for July. And the next month for the August, it will be prepared on the new set for input tax for August, output tax for August, and stock movement of August. And if the VAT registrant have more than one place of business, this set will prepare for head office and a set for branch for the month of July and for the month of August. Okay, this report shall be kept at a place of business at least 5 years, but not over 7 years. In case of the extension for the keeping, they will have the notification from the revenue office in case that they have the sign or the information that something should be clear before. Okay, that's when they will have the letter to extend for the period. But in case that in general case, the VAT registrant have to keep this for at least 5 years. After that, they can destroy all of the document, okay, to reduce for their storage cost. However, it can be extended to 7 years. Okay. For the input tax report, only deductible input tax shall be recorded in the input tax report, and this record shall be prepared within 3 days from the date that the tax point incurred. Okay. After preparing of the output tax and input tax for the seller and buyer for the sale transaction or buy transaction, within the 15th of the following month, they will prepare for VAT return form. Okay, this VAT return form shall be conclusion of the transaction in the month for selling transaction and buying transaction, and it will be conclusion as the one tax return. Okay, we will continue.